Now, Mrs. Reynolds, you know me better than that.
I'm not suggesting you tell us anything that can get the other women into trouble.
What I mean is, I do something for you, and you do something for me.
What are your terms? There's no way I can get the department to change its mind on the rehabilitation scheme.
No, obviously we have to tackle that from a different angle. What I'd like to see is an open family day once a month and a good work release program.
Oh, he'd have to get official departmental approval, but I think they're very workable schemes.
Do you think the department would agree?
I can't see them having any objections.
Well, no outlays.
Right. Agreed?
Yes.
Now, what can you tell us about this tape?
That tape would have given you all you need to know about Ferguson. Not only is she involved right up to her neck in every racket in the prison, but I can tell you things about her that'll make your hair curl. She's just about as good a manipulator as I am. But she destroys people in the process.
Just stick to the facts, Minnie. These are very serious allegations.
Oh, the booze and numbers racket are minor compared to the fact that she's indirectly involved in every bashing and death that's happened since she came. And she got rid of B.
Nothing surprises me. But you've got no concrete proof of any of this.
Oh, the women will back me up. I guess that's not enough, eh?
Sorry, Minnie. Wild accusations are continually being levelled at officers. The tape from this would have helped, though, judging from what you said was on it.
Well, Sonya has a copy, I'm positive of it.
Does she?
It'd be in the interests of all of us if you could get that other tape, Mrs. Reynolds. And it'd certainly help drive a big, hefty nail into Ferguson's coffin.
Wasn't a bit like last time. The kids were really beaut. And Diane, she lost the packet of the races and didn't even stop laughing.
How was your day, Lizzie?
Oh, really nice, thanks, Min.
I'm glad.
Kind of wait until I finish eating.
Just come along with me, students. Right now.
Do you see that? What's on her nose? What's the matter with Sonya?
She's been questioned about her dealings with Ferguson.
You lied to the governor.
Not exactly, Lizzie. I pointed the finger at Sonya. Mrs. Reynolds now knows all about the capers involving Ferguson.
No wonder you were gone so long. Well, what did Mrs. Reynolds say?
Shut up, Pixie. Lagging's not on, no matter what.
I understand that, Lizzie. But in this case, the most important thing for all of us is to get rid of Ferguson, isn't it? How many more of us are going to disappear, be bashed, die even because of her? It meant dobbing Sonya in. It was the only thing to do, and I have no regrets.
Yeah, I think Minnie's right. I mean, there are exceptions to every rule, you all know that.
Maybe there are. But laggers are still the scum of the earth.
Oh, I understand why you want the tape, Mrs. Reynolds. But in here, everything has a price on it.
I'd call that blackmail.
I call it insurance. Insurance that everybody gets what they deserve after the transaction.
You're wasting your time, Stevens. I'll pull this place apart until I find it.
What makes you think it's in the prison?
What do you want?
Two things. Firstly, immunity from the prosecution regarding the rackets. And secondly, maximum remissions for my parole.
You know I can't grant those concessions, Stevens. That's something the department will have to rule on.
I understand perfectly, Mrs. Reynolds, and I'm more than willing to wait. You see, I'm extremely cooperative.
Am I intruding?
You could say that.
I'm sorry. You still think I did the wrong thing?
Too bloody right I do.
But something had to be done. You must realise that, Lizzie.
All I know is that the top dog lagged. B'd never have done a thing like that.
Yes. I changed the rules, didn't I? But the end result is the same. We understood how important it was to get rid of Ferguson, and so do I. They've all tried before. But this time it'll work.
I still don't think it was right.
Lizzie, it'd be so much better in here without someone like Ferguson around. She brings the worst out in people. With her gone, we can try and help some of the weaker ones. Make them realise they've got something positive to offer.
Bee used to say that.
She was right. We're all in here together, whether we like it or not. And we've all got to help each other survive the course. But with someone round like Ferguson, it's a pretty hard thing to do.
Yeah, this dump's never been the same since she came. Everybody at each other's throats.
Well, we're going to change that. But I'll need your support.
What can I do?
The women look up to you, Lizzie. If you don't back me, nobody will. And if that happens, the freak will win again.
Oh, we can't let that happen, can we? I'll leave me knickers till later. We'll go and straighten the others out.
It's quite clear, Governor. You've been sold a bill of goods.
Have I, Miss Ferguson?
These allegations are ridiculous.
A lot of the women are prepared to substantiate them.
Oh, I'm sure they are. But it doesn't mean they're true, does it?
You may be right, Miss Ferguson, but we do have to go through the motions nevertheless.
Yes, well, with all due respect, sir, you do have to understand these women. They don't take too kindly to an officer who expects them to stick to the rules.
Explain that.
Well, now, Stevens, for instance. She's just had a loss of privileges for her involvement in a gambling and illicit alcohol racket. Well, of course she's going to try and get back at me.
All right, Miss Ferguson, we realise prisoners do try to retaliate. But how do you explain this?
Ah, yes, young Mitchell's tape. She fell down the stairs, sir, and in the process damaged the tape. I thought I might be able to fix it for her.
Well, that's an admirable sentiment.
I see. Where's the missing tape, then?
Oh, I didn't know that it was missing. It was certainly in there when I left the staff room. Mrs. Morris can tell you that.
Come in. Thank you, Miss Riley. Now, Stevens, your requests will be granted in return for the tape you told me about. Did you bring it with you?
I'm sorry, Mrs. Reynolds, I don't know what you're talking about.
Would you prefer to speak to us alone, Stevens?
About that tape you mentioned?
Yes.
I'm sorry, Mrs. Reynolds, but I don't know about any tape that could help you.
Here, let me.
Okay, thanks. Better not let anyone else see you do this.
No, you girls work pretty hard as it is.
Stevens!
You'd better have a good reason for that little charade in the governor's office, or you won't be looking quite so smug when I'm finished with you.
Of course I have. But you must admit I'd be better off without you.
Oh, nice try. What went wrong?
I changed my mind. It's better the devil you know than the devil you don't.
Oh, come on, Stevens. I can't imagine you passing up a chance to get out of here. Not unless something went wrong. And I'm prepared to buy it. For now. So you just watch yourself in the future, Stevens. Any more clever tricks and you'll be selling tickets to your own funeral. And get that stuff into the laundry.
Oh, timed that well, didn't you? Well, you can put it in the bag till tomorrow.
Running off at the mouth again, Donovan? You've been doing a lot of that lately, haven't you? And it's all been a waste of time. Ladies, you'll all be thrilled to know that I am going to be around for a long time yet. It didn't work, ladies. You're going to have to try a hell of a lot harder than that to beat me at my game. Now get out of here, the lot of you.